Santa Barbara Channel is just below Point Conception, a major biogeographic break along the Southern California coast. The channel is between the Santa Barbara mainland and the Northern Channel Islands. It's a really productive area where you get a lot of upwelling of cold, deep, nutrient-rich water that fuels phytoplankton blooms and lush kelp forests along the coast.
The National Science Foundation recognized that a lot of ecological processes occur over time scales and spatial areas that are larger than what one can study in a typical three-year NSF grant. So in 1980, they established six LTER sites that formed part of what they called a long-term ecological research network. In the year 2000, they decided they wanted to broaden the network to include coastal sites. And so we put together a proposal that focused on kelp forests as the principal habitat of interest and how kelp forests interact with processes occurring on land as well as in the ocean. We were funded in April of 2000. We've had over the years, on average, we have about 20 or so faculty level researchers involved in the project, 20 or so graduate students.
So it really builds on a long history of study of kelp forests going back decades at UCSB and at the Marine Science Institute.
Giant kelp is considered a foundation species, which means it provides a structure and habitat as well as food for a whole community and ecosystem of species. And so we look not only at giant kelp, but we look at the entire community of giant kelp.
We estimate about 50 to 60% of the species of invertebrates on the beach are supported directly by kelp that comes from the kelp forest. So Santa Barbara, UC Santa Barbara in particular, has some of the richest beaches in the world in terms of intertidal invertebrates. And I think a lot of that reason is because of this connectivity with kelp forests.
You know, there's fisheries that depend on giant kelp forests, spiny lobsters, sea urchins. You know, it's a wonderful place to go diving. And so there's a lot of tourism recreation that takes place in kelp forests, recreational fishing, in addition to the commercial fishing. It's also important for the cycling of carbon, of nutrients. So kelp photosynthesizes, so it's taking carbon from the atmosphere. And so it's, you know, it's important ecologically, it's important economically, it's important culturally.
We know that kelp forests fluctuate over the years and over long periods of time. And the focus of a lot of our research on the SBC LTER is to understand those fluctuations, how those affect the entire ecosystem that depends on kelp as a foundational species, and what processes, natural and human, are driving those fluctuations. The Santa Barbara Channel is a great place to study kelp forests because the main campus of UCSB and our field station, essentially, is right here on the ocean with easy access to the kelp forests by all the investigators on the project, by students, undergraduates and graduate students. We can incorporate field trips to the kelp forest or to the beach in classes. And UCSB's diving program training young scientific divers is the largest in the state. So we have really great access to coastal ecosystems here at UCSB, which is unique among California universities.
Santa Barbara is on the ocean. It's easy to get to kelp forests, whether that's diving in the kelp forest, coming out here and doing drone surveys of kelp forests. It makes it a lot more practical to get undergraduates and grad students involved.
There's so many great resources on this campus: the diving community, the diving program, marine operations, the small boat fleet that we have here. So the infrastructure on campus really allows us to do that kind of work.
There are many unique ways to collaborate at the SBC LTER, especially with work that spans from climate change biology all the way down to management. We're able to look at things from so many different points of view, which is essential as we move forward to solve these larger issues. I myself have been able just to have many conversations with people far outside my discipline, and that has helped really round out my perspective as a scientist.
One of the reasons LTRs and projects like LTRs are very powerful is that they provide a big infrastructural data platform or a bunch of resources that allow multiple interests to study the same system at the same time.
In over 20 years of operation, Santa Barbara Coastal LTER is, I think, the best known long-term study of kelp forests in the U.S. and perhaps the world. The data sets and experiments run by SBC continue to inform us about how the environment and biology interact to shape the amazing kelp forests that are a critical part of California's coastal ecosystems.